So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to Goddess Chakra Dance, a journey out of your head and into your body, a chance for you to rewire, rejuvenate, recalibrate your mind, body, and spirit through the chakra system, through the goddess archetypes. And this is our journey today for us to do all of those things, to let go of what doesn't serve us and to bring in what does. So grab yourself a yoga mat, grab yourself a bolster, grab yourself some earphones. If you have them, that always is better for sound. And if you have a diffuser, then pop some oil in your diffuser. Today, you might want to put in frankincense because we're concentrating on the wise woman. We're concentrating on the third eye. So yes, distraction. We're going to keep our eyes closed during the dance. We're going to try and take away distraction and just really center in on what our body needs. So today we are focusing on the wise woman. So day 13. So yesterday was Friday the 13th, the day of the goddess. Yoo-hoo! So today is day 13. And each week we go through the seven different chakras. So we're nearly at the end of week two, and so many of you are showing up and doing the work and watching the replays on YouTube. And, you know, just keep sending me the feedback because I will keep tweaking in order to give you what you need. So feedback is always good. So day 13, the wise woman. The wise woman. The wise woman, the third eye is between the two eyes. It's the drishti, it's the focus. It's the showing up. And the showing up is sadhana, you know, in yogic terms, sadhana. And it's discipline. It means discipline. It means showing up every day, or showing up as much as you can, supposedly every day, in order to change the way that you live. And it's really changing my life. And that's why I'm sharing this with you. This is my practice. You know, this is my practice that I do every day. This isn't, you know, a money-making spin or something like that. This is what I do every day, and I want to share it with other women. It's a way of you really kind of understanding in your body who you are. So the wise woman is the focus of the day. It's like sitting in, listening in to the words that are coming through from your subconscious, listening to the words that are coming through from your higher self. It's all coming in through the third eye, maybe coming in like a thread from the front of your head, your consciousness to your subconscious, bringing it forward. So getting out of the monkey mind is so important. We are constantly on that bullshit monkey mind every day, saying the same things over and over and over and over. So what we need to do, swipe it, push it aside like clouds in the sky, and see what else wants to come through today. So as you enter this process, just really allow yourself just to, yeah, drop out of the monkey mind and into the body, and just let the thoughts be passed on. So let's take the frankincense, put a couple of drops in your hand, rub it in your hand, take some deep breaths, and then sigh it out. I've really put lots on today. So just notice how you come out of the sympathetic and into the parasympathetic, meaning out of the fight, flight, and freeze, the tension, into the rest and digest body, your nervous system that you want to really be in to do this practice today. Okay. So let's just begin our practice. Let us begin our practice. If there's any problem with sound, don't forget to put a thumbs down in the comments, and then I will know to check it out. And if more than one of you do it, I know it's a problem my end. So we're going to start with the uncoiling of the Shakti energy, the divine feminine energy that we have coiled around our root chakra, around the bottom of our spine, this kundalini, this energy, imagining a snake, a serpent coiled around. We're just going to uncoil that serpent so that we can bring up the divine feminine energy from Shakti Earth, Mother Earth, and bring it round into our body. So let us begin. Okay, so half sound to start with, and then you can turn it up. So let us begin breathing in and sighing it out. So breathing in and sighing it out. Just really shake it out. Anything that's stale, stuck in the muscles. You're gonna feel tight here in the morning after sitting all day. The three. And two. And one. Sigh it out of your mouth. Okay, now we're going to take some deep breaths in. Into your diaphragm. And then Ujjayi, ocean breath it out. Closing your mouth. Through your yoni. Up through all your chakras. Imagining that center line. Pushing the stale air out of your chakras. Out of the body. Through the center line. For three. And two. And one. Okay, well done. Okay, so now I'm gonna do some fire breathing. Forgot to say, if you've got any tissues, you might want them as we do the fire breath. So shrugging our shoulders, pulling in our Mula Bandha, pulling in our pelvic floor nice and tight, shrugging our shoulders, breathing through our nose. For three, and two, and one. Breathe in, sigh it out, hands on your shoulders. Okay, so hands on your shoulders, elbows up, side to side, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Twisting gently, if you're used to it, twist however far you need to go to get a feel, but be careful. For three, and two, and one. Sigh it out of your mouth, feel it in your palms. Ooh, it tingles. Okay, up onto all fours. Okay, onto all fours, looking up, breathing in and breathing out. So sticking your bottom out, then breathing up, Ujjayi, ocean breath it up. Really arch your back, wiggle your back. Breathe into your back and thighs. Muscle release. For three. Two. And one. Okay, into child's pose. Open your legs. Stretch your arms out. Really open your legs wide. Really fall between them. Really take a little bounce and just feel yourself opening up your hips and thighs. This is a really good emotional release when you open up your hips and thighs. Sigh it out. And then into a cobra, just stretching out your back. Just clicking and clunking. Back to child's pose. Open your legs. Stretch your arms and then relax. Okay, good. And then up onto all fours. And then we're going to go round, breathing in and out. In. So you're just breathing out your mouth. Pushing all the stale air out of your mouth. When I first started doing this, I didn't get any sound. But when you do it for a while, you really appreciate and know where to push out. So three and two and one. Stretch out. Keep breathing. Go into a downward dog. A downward dog. Stretching out your arms, bending your knees, and then walking slowly to your feet, and then come up to stand. Yes, well done. Sighing it out of your mouth, feeling it in your palms, just letting it just be in your body. Start to be in your body. That's it. We are so cut off from our bodies. We just go, okay, I'll just ignore that. I'll just listen to what my crazy mind is saying. No more. So to stay in our bodies, we can do the shakeout, the tribal shakeout. Just letting go, bending your knees, shrugging your shoulders, letting it all fall out. Stimming, shaking around the body, regulating the nervous system as we go. Maybe shaking to the floor, rolling up, shaking out. But do whatever you want. We'll do whatever you want. It's just about, just make sure you do this. Keep your mouth open. Keep the air coming in and out, yeah? Keep the stale air coming out and the fresh air coming in. Out of your mouth, feel it in your palms. Okay, so we let go of what doesn't serve us, and we will continue to be honest, to let go and receive, give and receive the whole way through. So letting go, taking in, depending on where you're at in the moment, but that's the beginning of the letting go, the big letting go before we move into the chakras. So now we are moving proper into the chakras, properly into the chakras. So holding on to your yoni, I used to say perineum, but we're going to get real. We're going to get real and we're going to be realistic, holding on to your yoni, your opening to the world, feeling the pulse of the Shakti energy, the divine feminine energy that is in the earth coming up into your body. So clearing away all fear, clearing away our familial relationships, our family relationships that are difficult, making and cutting away old patterns and giving us a stable future, a stable foundation to build upon. Feeling safe in our body. So in order to do that, we must recognize that we are part of the whole, the Shiva Shakti, divine masculine, divine feminine energy, the golden thread coming through our bodies, so that we want to feel connected to Mother Earth and Father Sky. So the most beautiful analogy or metaphor is the grandmother oak, stretching up into the sky with her stable trunk, her deep roots and her long branches. She is such a beautiful, beautiful creature, the tree, the oak tree, the grandmother oak, giving us good foundations and stability and deep roots. So imagining now lifting your toes back onto the floor, imagining those deep roots going through the soil, through the clay, chalk, mud, mycelium, water, all the different layers, down into the earth, spreading far and wide, and then coming round and wrapping the roots around the red ruby core of the earth, bringing that red ruby up through all the layers of the earth, through your toes, between your calves, between your knees, between your thighs, into your yoni. Up through your sacral chakra, your orange sacral chakra, into the yellow solar plexus, the green heart, the blue throat, the purple third eye, and out to your head as white light. So feeling that energy, just feel that energy coming around your body through your chakra. This is your whole system. This is your whole life. From here to here is your whole life. You can unblock all these energy centers by doing this practice every day, for sure. So just feeling the energy in your palms that you've created. Feel the tingles and the protectiveness of the white light, the shimmering white light around your body, the angel wings. Visualize in your mind. Sigh it out. Okay, so starting with the root chakra, we are going to be opening our palms, feeling the primal energy of Mother Earth. So you can touch the floor, you can drum high, low, fast, slow, but it's all about beats, okay? Feeling the beat through your body. So let us feel into those tribal beats right now. Keep breathing through your mouth. Thank you.
side out of your mouth. Feel it in your palms. Remember, you can always go back over the playlist later and just dance on your own, doing the full 7-8 minutes. So just breathe it, sigh it out. Feel it in your palms. Yeah. Moving into the sacral chakra, moving into the womb space. So just holding onto your womb, maybe making a womb mudra. Your temptress and your creatrix, your sacred sexuality, your womb space, your watery flow, the place that we create from, the spaciousness in our body that we create from is in the sacral chakra. So we also hold shame, and maybe the fear that's coming up from the root can get stuck in this area. So women tend to have, you know, different issues with the womb space, whether you've had children or not. You know, we create from this space, we create children, we create birth, new ideas, new creations, but we have to keep this space in flow, this space healthy. So, and it starts not just, it starts in our womb, but it goes all the way around, right? It's like a whole, it's a whole system of centering here that we need to open up the hips, get our hips in flow. Okay, getting our hips, our lower back, all of this in flow, getting the juices going. Even if you're in menopause, even if you're no longer bleeding, you need to be keeping this going, especially keeping this going when you're no longer in the time cycles of the bleed, but you still are in the cycles because you are a woman. So the cycles of the moon, the cycles of your womb, the cycles of your womb, the cycles of the moon. So let's just keep this going, right? Circling, circling, figure of eight, forward and back. Bringing in your whole body. So remember, this is about exploring your muscles. So when your muscles feel tight, you want to bring your whole body into flow, not just your hips. So, you know, you can just really feel into your body like no one is watching, because no one is, okay? So let us go into that flow now and explore the myth of the cave. Good song for this, the myth of the cave. The womb is your cave, the place you go to repair.
Oh.
Really pushing your thighs out now, your hips.
Cords that knot and threads that bind tell the tale of humankind. From long ago into future return, all wisdoms of life's learned. Out of the cave the shining ones rise, open eyes. We weave a new myth into the timeline.
Feel it in your palms. Okay. Take a breath. Take a sip of your tea, your herbal tea, your water, your cacao, whatever you have. And just sigh it out. Feel it in your palms. Creating that energy. Clearing away. Rewiring, rejuvenating, recalibrating the body. So moving into the solar plexus, into the warrior goddess, okay? Into the fire, into showing up, to playing full out, to building resilience against the outside world, or just building resilience within. making clear boundaries of yes and no, cutting away when our limiting beliefs saying no, or saying yes when we mean no. Let's just cut that away, cutting the cords, cutting the things that no longer serve us. Okay, cutting away and showing up, playing full out, listening to our gut instinct. What is our gut telling us? Listening into the body instead of the monkey mind is so important. So always check in how it feels right in the center of your core. So burning away all the fear and the shame up in the furnace of the solar plexus and watching the ashes rise, watching the phoenix rise. So if you want to join me, then please turn on your cameras and I will place you, I will put you into gallery view. It will only record me, so do not fear. Beautiful, so well done. Good, 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 good. Constance, Chloe, Alana, Coral. Yes, Elaine, beautiful. So, let us dance together. Let us all begin this dance together. Looking at each other. Fabulous. Okay, let us do this. Playing full out, right? I want to see full out play here. Bringing it in, opening your eyes. So good to see you all. Breathing, keep moving, taking up space.
Take a sigh out of your mouth, feel it in your palms. So good. How amazing are you on a Saturday morning joining me? So good, so good. Oh, you know, really, you don't know how nice it is to have the energy in the room at the same time. So beautiful. Well done. Just feel it in your palms. Take a sip. And just well done for showing up in your full power as the warrior goddess, even when you don't feel like it necessarily. You're kind of making that effort to come forward, playing full out, to be seen, to be heard. And just to remind some of you who don't know, I think quite a lot of you don't know, I had to have hypnotherapy to put myself in front of the camera a few years ago, okay? And this is how far I've come in letting myself be seen and heard, okay, on camera. I've never been shy, but being on camera was something I had to move through, a limiting belief that was stuck in my power, in my solar plexus. So, you know, dysmorphia, how we see ourselves, is an interesting thing, okay? And it can be overcome and we can step into our power no matter what. So well done. Sigh that out. Feel the tingle. Moving to the heart space, moving to the inner child and the maiden, letting go of rejection and abandonment and bringing in joy and peace and harmony. We tap into the inner child, tapping into the thymus, tapping into our immunity. You are enough. You are worthy. You are loved. So I am enough. I am worthy. I am loved. Repeat this mantra to yourself. And the maiden is in the same place, our inner child, our inner younger self, the maiden, the younger self, the maiden. Very, very important to know that there are no mistakes. There are only initiations into the goddess, into the woman you desire and deserve to be. So continuing on the energy medicine and touch and sensuality and sexuality and cross-bodying the hemispheres, cross-bodying the masculine and feminine, both east and west and north and south across the body, right? So this is where we are having Shiva and Shakti cross-bodying, beautiful, down through the body, up through the yoni, across the breast, holding on to the maiden, into the heart space, through the chakras and around the energy body as white light. Feel that? I certainly do. And this understanding of the elements, north, south, east, west, water, air, fire, and earth, are within us and without us. So let us begin the little choreography of the heart chakra. Oh, yes, this is a nice one. Let's do this. Happy. Tapping into the thymus.
Holding me close.
side out of your mouth. Takes you right back, takes me right back to Saturdays in my childhood. Just breathing out, feel it in your palms. Yes, am I showing my age there? Am I showing my age there? Yeah, 51 and still going strong. Woohoo! Yeah. If you're an 80 child, a 90 child, what they call a tweenie, is it a tweenie? I'm not sure. And a millennial, a couple of millennials here, I know. Anyway, breathe it out. Side out, feel it in your palms. Ah. All right, so feeling the love, the compassion from that heart space, burning up that shame and fear in the furnace and then into the heart, giving yourself some love and compassion, moving in now to the ethereal, into the spirit realm, the spirit chakras, into the throat, into the medicine woman. So grab yourself a cushion or a bolster, come and sit down on the floor. You might want your jumper or shawl or whatever you have back on as your body drops in temperature. I am having severe sweats at the moment, so we'll be fine. So moving into speaking your truth. This is what happens, comes up through the heart space. So it needs to come out now, right? It needs to come out as truth. You need to stand in your power, speak your truth. Say what you mean what you say, making sure it's congruent with what you think. So speak kindly to yourself and therefore to others. So if you have the eucalyptus oil at hand, I would invite you to bring eucalyptus and frankincense to every session if you have, because it's just a really nice way to move into and open up the spirit elements and making them receiving. This is where we receive spirit, right? So opening up as much as possible where we can. So this is mantra. This is song, this is vibration in the throat. So whatever you can manage. So this is the heavenly prayer of light. So we're calling in, it's like 20 minutes long in full. You can do it outside of this space again, if you wish, like everything else, but just doing 5 minutes of calling in the heavenly prayer of light. Again, from the directions, from up and down, from side to side, east, west, north, south. So root chakra, if you want to be rooted, you can do this mudra, or you can just have your hands down or up if you want to receive. You can still be moving in this. This is a stillness, this is still a movement. You still have the ability just to push out anything else that needs to come out of the body and just start to, yeah, just start to slow down. Rather than just going to stillness, we have the opportunity to slow down here. So closing your eyes, taking some deep breath. Do what you can.
Love before me, love behind me, love at my left, love at my right, love above me, love below me, love in me, love in my surroundings, love to all, love to the universe. Peace before me, peace behind me, peace at my left, peace at my right, peace above me, peace below me, peace in my surroundings, peace to all, peace to the universe. Light before me, light behind me, light at my left, light at my right, light above me, light below me, light in me, light in my surroundings, light to all, light to the universe. Love before me, love behind me, love at my left, love at my right, love above me, love below me, love in me, love in my surroundings, love to all, love to the universe. Peace before me, peace behind me, peace at my left, peace at my right, peace above me, peace below me, peace in my surroundings, peace to all, peace to the universe. Light before me, light behind me, light at my left, light at my right, light above me, light below me, light in me, light in my surroundings, light to all, light to the universe. Love before me, love behind me, love at my left, love at my right, love above me, love below me, love in me, love in my surroundings, love to all, love to the universe. Peace before me, peace behind me, peace at my left, peace at my right, peace above me, peace below me, peace in my surroundings, peace to all, peace to the universe. Light before me, light behind me, light at my left, light at my right, light above me, light below me, light in me, light in my surroundings, light to all, light to the universe. Love before me, love behind me, love at my left, love at my right, love above me, love below me, love in me, love in my surroundings, love to all, love to the universe. Peace before me, peace behind me, peace at my left, peace at my right, peace above me, peace below me, peace in my surroundings, peace to all, peace to the universe. Light before me, light behind me, light at my left, light at my right, light above me, light below me, light in me, light in my surroundings, light to all, light to the universe. Love before me, love behind me, love at my left, love at my right, love above me, love below me, love in me, love in my surroundings, love to all, love to the universe. Peace before me, peace behind me, peace at my left, peace at my right, peace above me, peace below me, peace in my surroundings, peace to all, peace to the universe. Light before me, light behind me, light at my left, light at my right, light above me, light below me, light in my surroundings, light to all, light to the universe.
Okay, and take a deep breath out, sigh it out, feel it in your palm. You can get really lost, right? So, moving now into the third eye. Yes, we are in the third eye. Suddenly lost myself. So into the third eye, if you have some frankincense, into that wise woman. Into that wise woman that we're focusing on today, allowing ourselves to listen to the whispers, to the downloads, to the things that are coming through from the subconscious, from the higher self, things that are coming through that we don't hear because we're too busy in the monkey mind, just going over and over and over the same old shit, right? So excuse my French, but there you go. Same old stuff in our mind over and over again. We need to bring forward. We need to bring forward what wants to come through, what we see ourselves being and doing. So looking into the light, focusing on the light. If you want to place yourself in the light, see what occurs, but allow the thoughts to come in, let them pass like clouds in the sky. So staying still, this is meditation, this is being, this is really important to regulate, just stopping. So hands down, rooting yourself, keeping still, 5 minutes. It's actually 3 minutes. You've been let off the hook today. Inside it out of your mouth, using your palms. So beautiful to hear the Tibetan bowls. And if you come to any of my in-person meets, then you will experience the bowls. And if you have one-to-one, you experience the bowls on your body. As I use the Tibetan bowls to heal on the body. So beautiful. Still, I think, the best way to heal. So just take a deep breath in and sigh it out. Feeling it into my palms. So now to the high priestess, lifting your arms up to the crown, literally lifting your arms up to reach the crown that you're going to place on your head. And we're going to embody the journey we've been on. I'm going to send you Reiki from my body to yours. Distance Reiki is very powerful, as well as in person. And we're going to open up all the chakras, opening up all the chakras to all possibilities today, opening up to everything that we need to feel to open up to our higher consciousness. And the higher consciousness, when we step into our high priestess and our higher selves, the women we deserve and desire to be, then the ripple effects are felt in our family. Trust me, in our family, with our children, with our husbands, our wives, out into our community, and the world and the universe, and opening up and being present and being healthy and loving can affect thousands of others. So here we go to do that now, to open up to all possibilities. Place your feet on the floor, your knees up. So come down into Savasana. Place your hands on your body. Make sure your back is firmly on the floor. Take a deep breath in, filling up your diaphragm. Breathing out, connecting again Shiva and Shakti through the golden thread in your body. Take another deep breath in again, and breathing out, seeing the air coming out through your yoni again. Breathing in and back through all your chakras and out through your yoni. So holding on to your yoni, feeling that pulse of the mother in your root chakra, the divine mother in your root chakra, the pulse of the earth. Feeling that connection, letting go of all fear, our attachment to family issues, cutting the cords. Feeling stable and secure now, safe in our own bodies. So let us feel safe in our own bodies and repeat the mantra. I feel safe in my body. I let go of all fear today. I feel safe in my body. I let go of all fear today. I feel safe in my body. I let go of all fear today. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. Send your Reiki love, healing, and light. I send your Reiki love, healing, and light into your sacral chakra, into your temptress and your creatrix, into that womb space. So making womb mudra. The portal of light going into womb space, giving it a rub, thanking it for having your children, your projects, the new ideas, your creativity, keeping you in flow. Repeat the mantra, I release all shame and I move through my day with ease and grace. I release all shame and I move through my day with ease and grace. I release all shame and I move through my day with ease and grace. And then moving to your solar plexus, I send you Reiki love, healing, and light into your warrior, into your goddess warrior, into your fire, your strength, your power, your why, your resilience, and your boundaries. Repeat the mantra, no more people pleasing today. No more people pleasing today. No more people pleasing today. I stand in my power and my true strength as a warrior goddess. I stand in my power, in my true strength as a warrior goddess. I stand in my power as in my true strength as a warrior goddess. Take a deep breath in. Sigh that out. And then to your heart space, to the inner child, to the maiden, to I am enough, I am worthy, I am loved. I am enough, I am worthy, I am loved. I am enough, I am worthy, I am loved. Repeat this mantra. And then repeat the mantra, there are no mistakes, there are only initiations into God, into the goddess. There are no mistakes, there are only initiations into the goddess. There are no mistakes, there are only initiations into the goddess. Take a deep breath in, sigh that out. Remember, the goddess is you. We are all the goddess. We are all the goddess. So into the throat chakra, into the medicine woman, I send you Reiki love, healing, and light. The power to heal yourself through the words you speak and the food and the things that you put into your body. So repeat the mantra, I speak kindly to myself and I put in my body what nourishes me today. I speak kindly to myself and I put in my body what nourishes me today. I speak kindly to myself and I put in my body what nourishes me today. Take a deep breath in. Then to your third eye, to your wise woman, to your opening of your drishti, your focus. To your third eye. Mm. to your wife or an opening up your third eye, I send you Reiki love, healing and light. Repeat the mantra, I hear the whispers coming through today, I know what I must do. I hear the whispers coming through today, I know what I must do. I hear the whispers coming through today, I know what I must do. And if you don't know what you must do, when you say the mantra, you are bringing and calling in that stillness. It's the weekend, find time again to be still, to hear if it didn't come through already. I send you Reiki love, healing and light. Take a deep breath in, sigh it out. And then again, just reaching up to your crown, bringing it up, see the jewels, all the gorgeous, great big rubies and diamonds and amethysts and all your favorites, right? Quartz, rose quartz, these are all my favorites, all on the crown, and you're gonna place it on your head. Place your hands behind your head, put your feet together, open up all your chakras, take a deep breath in. Just have a sigh there. I send you Reiki love, healing and light into all your chakras, into your higher self, into your queen, into your high priestess. I am the high priestess and I rule with humility, love and kindness for myself and others. I am the high priestess and I rule with humility, love and kindness for myself and others. I am the high priestess and I rule with humility, love and kindness for myself and others. Take a deep breath in, sigh it out. Give yourself a hug. Give yourself, bring your knees to your chest and give yourself a great big hug. And if you can, go into happy baby, grab your toes, rock from side to side, holding on to your toes. Another hip opener, another letting go. Opening the hips is always letting go. So if you want to stay here, stay here. You'll roll onto your side and come up to seated. Come onto your bolster. Place your hands on your body. Take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. And again, take a deep breath in. Sigh it out. And another one. Take a deep breath in. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a beautiful, beautiful day. Love and light. And join me again tomorrow, for we are still doing this tomorrow. And if you have your diary, don't forget to write your gratitude or what comes up for you in your diary. And yeah, let me know how you're getting on. Lots of love and light, and have a beautiful weekend. Mwah. Take care.